Good evening all of you. Today we are going to study about functions in C++. In our previous session we have seen the introductory part of the object oriented programming language. Yesterday we have seen the features of C programming language as well as features of C++ programming language. We have also seen the difference between object oriented programming language and procedure oriented programming language. So the rest of the part, this C++ language also support, like the decision making statements, loop control structures, all the features of C language was supported by C++. So you can try some problems of C programming language using any decision control statement, loop control structures, switch case, right? Try to perform certain programs of C programming language and convert it into C++ programming language. What you have to do is, instead of stdio.h, you are going to use iostream.h as the header file for input and output. Another thing is, the input output statement, like in C language we have printf and scanf, you just have to replace it by cin and cout. So your homework is to convert at least 10 programs of C programming language to C++. Today we are going to study about the functions in C++. So in today's session we are, our main focus is on the points like returning types in main function, function prototype, call by reference, call by value method, then inline function, which is available in C++ only. This function is not available in any other language. It is supported by only C++. Then we are going to study about default argument to the functions. Then at last we are going to study function overloading in C++. Okay, so what do you mean by user defined function in any programming language and how to define it? We have already used so many inbuilt functions with the help of certain header files like string.h, mat.h and any other header files which covers many different inbuilt functions. But today we are going to study about user defined function. And we already studied the syntaxes of user defined function in C programming language. Like if I want to add two numbers, there is no addition function in programming language. So we can have integer add in bracket integer comma integer and at last we give semicolon. This is called as declaration of the function, or it is also called as function prototype, correct? So this is called user defined function, which takes three things. One is return type, second is function name, and third is argument list. And body of the function is written in opening and closing bracket, that is called as block in the function, right? So in C++ also we are going to follow the same format of writing the function that we have studied in C programming language. Every program in C++ also have a main program. And execution of all the programs starts with the main program, and later on in the main program we are going to call some other functions. Okay, the same way as we have seen in C programming language. This small template for writing a main program, integer main, and then there are many lines of code. At last we are returning 0, because we have used integer here, we must return 0 to indicate that the program is successfully ended in C++. If you see how to declare function, this is the example given here, float volume, which take three parameters. So this is the function which calculates the volume of a cube. This is the function which calculate the volume of a square, and so on. So to call that function, we can declare a line like this, equal to volume in bracket b1 w1 comma h1. It means it takes three parameters to execute. Now what do you mean by call by value and call by reference? In call by value method, we have seen three important points about call by value method and call by reference method in C programming language. It is similar in C++ also. In call by value method, what we do is, there is one calling program and another is called program, called function you can say, right? So in call by value method, one copy of the actual arguments is given to the formal arguments. It means we are copying it, actual arguments into the formal arguments. The called function works on the copy but not on the actual parameters. So any changes that you make into the call function will not going to reflect into the calling function. So that is called as call by reference. And in call by value method, when you it actually copies one copy of actual argument to formal arguments, any changes made by the called function are seen by not seen by calling function. So there are no harms to the actual parameters in call by value method, but in call by reference method we pass one copy of the addresses, we pass the address of the actual arguments to the formal arguments. So whenever we pass the address to the call function directly works on the actual arguments, right? So any changes made by the call function are going to reflect into the actual parameters that we have already studied in C programming language. It is same as in C++. There is no difference in call by reference and call by value in C++. Also, we have already seen some examples on swapping of two numbers using call by value method and call by reference method. Just use the same program and convert that program into C++. Try to execute that program on IDE1.com portal. Then how do you return a value to the caller? By using the return statement like this, if x is greater than y, we return x and otherwise we return y. This way we can return the variable values to the calling program. Very important point today is inline functions in C++. So this function is always asked in the examination for 5 to 10 marks in the university examination. Okay. As we know, in conventional programming, whenever a function gets called, the compiler jumps from calling line to the function definition. During the process, some time gets elapsed. For example, one of the objective of using function in a program is to save the memory space, which becomes appreciable when a function is likely to be called many times. However, whenever you call a function, it takes a lot of extra time in executing a series of instructions for tasks such as jumping from main program to the function definition, saving the values into the register, pushing arguments into the stack and returning to the calling function. When a function is small and a substantial percentage of time, execution time is spent in such overheads. So it is very time consuming process in conventional programming. So C++ has provided us a solution called as inline function. We can make any function which is defined in one or two lines, which is very small, the coding is very small, as a inline function. Now what do you mean by inline function? Inline functions are those functions which invoked inline, right? So whenever you call the function, the compiler in this process need not have to jump from the calling line to the function definition. The function code itself is available at the place where the function gets called, right? So whenever the function is called, the actual code replaces the function call. It means that the jumping time that was taken in the conventional function programming gets reduced here. Jumping is avoided in a inline function definition. Okay. Then a question may comes into your mind, how to make a function as an inline function. Just put a keyword inline in front of the function header line, then that function becomes inline function. For example, here if you see a cube function is written and we have written only a word inline in front of the header line of that function, then this function can be treated as an inline function. If the function is called like this in a program later on, cube of 3, there cube of 2.5 plus 1.5, it going to execute successfully and it gives you a proper result. It is easy to make any function inline. What we need to do is just put inline keyword in front of the function definition. We must take care of writing the function or making the function inline, the speed benefit of inline functions diminish as the function grows in size. If the function is too large, we cannot make such functions as inline function. If function size is increased, the request given by the user to the compiler may be rejected. Whenever you make inline function, it doesn't mean that the compiler by default considered it as an inline function. It is just a request by the user to the compiler to treat the function as a inline function. The request may be accepted or it may be rejected. That totally depends upon the size of the function. So this type of function written here like this can be considered as an inline function, because if you see, the function body consists of only one line of code. It is very small function, and such function can be considered inline. There are certain situations where the function cannot be considered as the inline function. The main objective of inline function is to avoid jumping tasks, correct? But if your function definition itself consists of the points such as for a function returning a value, if a loop, a switch case or go to exists in your code, then these are, if you see, switch case and go to are jumping statements. That must not be there in the coding or body of the function. If it is there, such function cannot be made as a inline function. For function returning values, if a return statement exists, as we know, return statement is also a jumping statement which transfers the control from one line to another line. It jumps, right? So if your function consists of inline return statement, that function also cannot be treated as a inline function. If a function contains static variable, that function cannot also be treated as an inline function, because static variables are the file global variables. So whenever those variables are accessed, the compiler has to jump from one line to another line. Jumping should be avoided in inline function. Then the fourth important point about not making any function as inline function is, if inline functions are recursive. As we know, in recursion also jumping happens, right? A function which calls itself again and again during the program execution is called inline function. So we should avoid recursive function, recursion, static variable, switch, go to, or any return statement inside the function body. Then and then only we can make such functions as inline function. Otherwise, the compiler rejects your request and it treats the request as the function as a normal function. It never gives you an error, right? If your function size is more than one line, it treats that function definition as a normal function definition. It never treats it as a inline function, and it never gives you error for inline function. Okay. Consider a small example on inline function. Yeah. There is a multiplication function, right? Multiplication which has two variable x and y, where we are going to perform multiplication here. It is considered made an inline function here. This is another function definition, division, where we are actually performing the division of two numbers. In the main program, we declare two variables, and then later on we are calling the multiplication division function here. This program runs faster than the conventional function programming, because here you have made two functions, multiplication and division, as inline. Okay. And the function definition consists of only a single line of code, and compiler accept your request and execute the program, execute the function definition in the main program itself by replacing the function call by the function body, actual code of the function. So this program executes faster than the conventional function program that we have seen previously. Okay. So this is the biggest advantage of inline function. For your note, please make sure that, and remember this thing, inline expansion makes a program run faster because the overhead of a function call and return is eliminated. However, it makes the program to take up more memory space because the statement that define the inline functions are reproduced at each point where the function is called. So a trade-off becomes necessary. So this is very, very important point from exam point of view, which always come for a 5 marks in many C++ university examination papers. Okay. Now we'll stop here and just recall